and for rigors and for tries, well, she lay in Plymouth Sound. Blue Peter at the foremost mast, she was for outward bound. We were waiting there for order to send us far from home. Well, our order came for Rio, boys, and then around Cape Horn. Well, we hoisted our treetop sails, and our anchors we did weigh. We bade our friends a kind farewell, and then we sailed away. We sailed away for Rio, and on our course didn't steer. 'Twas a many's a stormy day and night before Rio did appear. Well, when we arrived for Rio, we prepared for heavy gales. We battened all our rigging, boys, and bent out our new sails. From ship to ship they cheered us as we did sail along, and wished us pleasant weather in the rounding of Cape Horn. While bearing down Magellan Strait, well, it blew exceeding hard. While shortening sail, two gallant tires fell from the topmast yard. By angry seas, the ropes we threw from their poor hands were torn. And we were forced for to leave them to the sharks that prowl around Cape Horn. Well, when we got around the Horn, me boys, we had some glorious days. And very soon our killick dropped in Valparaiso Bay. Those pretty girls came down to us, I solemnly declare. They are far before those Plymouth girls with their long and curling hair. Oh, they love a jolly sailor lad who spends his money free. They laugh and sing and very merry be and have a jovial spree. But when our money is all gone, they won't on you impose. They are far before those Plymouth girls who'll pawn and sell your clothes. So farewell to Valparaiso, farewell for a while. Like all those Spanish girls all on the coast of Chile. And if I ever live to be paid off, I'll sit and sing this song. God bless those pretty Spanish girls who live around Cape Horn.
Of like you're getting to the women at the end of the day, like all the sharks and killing people is kind of superfluous to the end result. But we're going to delve in straight into the 1798 rebellion, and the Irish were unfortunately very good at failed rebellions, and this was one of them. And this is about a young man who starts his career in Dublin and as a kind of a street urchin as such, and ends up being transported to Botany Bay, and he basically tells the story from there on. He joins the militia men, the militia group. He was a young fella, and for anyone who doesn't know about the 1798 rebellion, it was trying to recreate the French Revolution and the American Revolution in Ireland, and through the help of the French and Uncle General Humbert and Wolfe Tone. And they nearly succeeded if it wasn't for, apparently, for a man called Grouche, who in Dublin we called him Grouchy, and just because of our accents. And but he apparently turned traitor, and he was a spy, and told that there was an invasion happening, and then unfortunately it ended up that instead of croissants and coffee in Ireland, there's tea and toast. And so it's called We're Bound for Botany Bay, and there's a chorus in this. Son, oh son, where are you gone? You're bound for Botany Bay. So you can sing along. I'm bound in exile from my native land as a traitor to the crown. Oh son, where are you gone? You're bound for Botany Bay. Well, all were poor, we did endure the worst of old John Bull. The deprivations of our lot, we swore we'd pay in full. Oh son, where are you gone? You're bound for Botany Bay. I was born and reared on the Dublin streets, a native wild and free. When I was young, I'd sport and run by the coom and liberties. Oh son, where are you gone? You're bound for Botany Bay. So I joined the brave militiamen, and we assembled in a band, and we marched on the fight to win for to free our native land. Oh son, where are you gone? You're bound for Botany Bay. Well, we fought hard, we fought long, but outnumbered 5-1. We were hunted through the lanes and streets, killed with pike and gun. Oh son, where are you gone? You're bound for Botany Bay. Well, some were hung on the gibbet spun, and woeful was their fate. I was taken to Kilmainham jail, my sentence to await. Oh son, where are you gone? You're bound for Botany Bay. Well, a jury found me guilty, and I stood my crime to pay. Well, the judge, he called out from the dock, you're bound for Botany Bay. Oh son, where are you gone? You're bound for Botany Bay. Well, I saw my aged father trembling at the bar. Likewise, I saw my mother tearing her white hair. Oh son, where are you gone? You're bound for Botany Bay. So they put me on a vessel moored at Customs House Quay. Well, the sailors stood around and jeered, no more this land you'll see. Oh son, your days are done, you're bound for Botany Bay. And I watched old Aaron fade from view, and tears did flood my eye. This verdant land I'll see no more until the day I die. Oh son, where are you gone? You're bound for Botany Bay. My name is James O'Donnell, in iron and chains I'm bound. in exile from my native land as a traitor to the crown. Oh son, where are you gone? You're bound for Botany Bay. Oh son, where are you gone? You're bound for Botany Bay.